this, you know, bipolar disorder is very prevalent in artists. There's always an inner struggle to get that piece of art out. Whether or not they choose to get rid of it, it's still impactful. But music is always a healer. Music's never let me down. I don't know, it's my religion. There's the idea that you can't truly know happiness unless you know sadness, so how can you really heal yourself unless you've hurt yourself? I'm still figuring out who I am, but I know that I'm not who I was.
We go live in 30.
I was under the delusion that we'd never break up.
In 10, get ready, John.
Alright.
In 3, 2, 1.
Now, how do you define human beings?
It is time for another.
Thank you very much. Another Radio 104.5 studio session. We are live in the Xfinity Performance Theater. Very happy to welcome Panic at the Disco.
Hello, hello. Very happy to be here. This is awesome.
The new album is Vices and Virtues, comes out on March 29th.
Correct.
Like, we'll start out just you guys talking to the camera, talking to the teamers, saying how outside you guys are about the new record.
Sweet.
Check 1, 2, 3, 4, testing. Sibilance. Check. 1.
Same thing. Just look at John.
You're good.
Okay.
Okay.
Cool. So I guess to start, maybe, could we talk a little bit about kind of the writing process for this record and kind of how it came together? I know it's kind of a long time in the making for you guys.
Yeah. It was a different process, just writing with the two of us, not having to worry about four opinions and talking about it with everybody, just two of us decide what we want. And that was a little easier in that aspect. So
it does still seem like a fresh start.
Mm-hmm.
And we were pretty close on where we wanted to go directionally when we started writing.
Yeah.
Still are. So I think it was nice, and it does kind of feel like even though it is still Panic, it does kind of feel like
it's a new Panic.
Yeah.
Documented,
yeah. The last time I had this many cameras on me, I was naked, and there was a donkey in the room.
Was that last night?
You know, it wasn't really a long thought process. We immediately decided, no, this, you know, we want to keep going. What we want to do is more in line with what we've done in the past, so we should, yeah, this is our band. Let's just keep it going. And you know, that was special for us to tell our fans, hey, we're going to keep doing this, and if, you know, you guys will support us, you know, we'd love your support, and this will make this as fun as possible for everyone. Man, this guy so badly wants me to say something about Ryan.
Yeah.
Every single question has been something like pushing me to.
I mean, you were telling me that they were like, you know, the same, just like,
yeah,
you know, breathe and kind of just relax,
right,
and be calmer, have all been awesome.
Good, right?
Yeah.
No, it totally makes a difference, because, you know, we get in there, and I usually get, like, really anxious. And
yeah.
I'm like, you know, but then I've like, controlling, you know, when I cross my leg, not shaking my foot, just, you know, thinking about the question and just being positive about it. So,
yeah.
Just breathe, really.
And
it's so true.
And it makes it easier, because, like, when we're calm, you can think about where you're going to sit,
mm-hmm,
you know?
Right.
You don't
it's not personal.
Get into it's just, something, yeah, it's like.
Exactly. It's just media. Come to realize.
From here on out, it'll be all about driving as many pre-orders to the web store as possible and
more on the merch side. We do have a new t-shirt that's hitting Hot Topic in the next week or so.
Yes.
Facebook and the YouTube, like, probably the biggest outlets we have. We're adding like 5,000 new fans on there a day, which is great.
Tomorrow night, big show, obviously, it'll be a big night. Packed in front of a lot of photo shoots, a lot of.
Take out whatever you want. I think it's good to keep you in the same, like, vibe.
I like these.
Yeah?
God, what could I even wear with this? Didn't have a hairy chest, but just a feathery chest. This is fun. we try a different vest under?
I think I'll try that. I'll try that.
I like that.
Okay. Cool.
And then we'll try the dress pant. Try this on.
Oh, that feels good.
That looks really cool.
It's a funny thing doing press, you know? It's a very peculiar process. You're just under a spotlight.
Initially, you know, like 5 or 6 years ago, when we had a lot more success than we ever thought that we would have, and then you're just instantly put in the position of, okay, you are a successful band, so you have to be that. You just have to be ready for 6 interviews a day. There is no, like, choosing when you want to move into that role. And so to have that so young, you know, all the questions and stuff, you know, even now, this is, you know,
it's just important to question things, I guess. Then you start to become a different person.
You are the one who is vain. You are the one who is compassionate. You are the one who is courageous. You are the one who is doubtful. You are the one who gloats. You are the one who chokes. You are the one who is grateful. You are the one who judges. Who saves. You are the one who is arrogant. You are the one who is honorable. You are the one who is disloyal. You are the one who is honest. You are the one who is envious. You are the one who is generous. You are the one who brags. You are the one who is brave. You are the one who is impatient. You are the one who is jealous. You are the one who is weak.
Cool, so I think that this beginning part we cut out, and it starts on... Yeah, right.
Okay, yeah, starts at A.
No, it starts today.
Okay.
The whole piece starts today.
Yeah, the whole.
Hey, Mark.
You know?
Oh. Oh, not even close. Oh. That was horrible.
Are you doing a pick?
No, bottle cap. I want to see it.
Oh. You would say the pick, you could fucking. Oh, shit. Sorry, Adam.
Oh! He didn't even flinch.
Let's just make it go one time, so that would be 8 bars.
Okay.
Or wait. Yeah, 8 bars.
And then do you want me kind of softer at that? Because I was playing really loud.
Yeah, beautiful little English, like a little quieter, and yeah. Because I think we're all going to kind of tone it down, all instruments and vocals. But yeah, just that one time, so it doesn't repeat. 16 bars. That'll be good. Cool. Sounds awesome, though.
Yeah.
I mean, if we have enough... you know, direct inputs. I think we'll be fine. It would just sound cool, you know, like the group vocal, like Kill Tonight, and then the harmonies on Say What You Mean, you know, just like that huge verb, spring verb.
We just got done rehearsing with the string players.
Oh, how'd it go?
Good. Couple things, though, with the stage, I guess we can't, the risers, they only have 4x8, and then you combine 2 to get an 8x8, and 4x8 is too small for me, so this stage is, like, pretty much the exact same size. We were kind of measuring it out. I mean, the only thing is, like, dude, the stage is 14 feet deep, and so 8, like, I'd be taking my riser would be more than half.
Yeah, you have 6 feet in front of it.
You know, so, I mean, it's taken a lot to, like, here.
So, yeah, how's it going? So, it's like, one. Double time. You have to go, dun. So, wait, try it again, just go. Thank you.
stupid trick.
That's stupid.
That's stupid. You're stupid.
You're stupid.
Hello, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the show. We're back at the disco. We hope you enjoy what the night has in store.
Are you switching
guitars? Welcome to our little soiree.
Yeah.
Okay, so we both got to switch.
Yeah.
And that's it?
That's pretty much it.
Yeah.
Do you have it? Like, do you
yes,
know, like, finalize what you're going to say?
Hello! Good evening! Ladies and gentlemen, how are you feeling tonight? We are Panic at the Disco. We'd like to thank you for coming out tonight. We have a very special night planned for you. We're going to be playing some new numbers, as well as some old ones. So we hope you enjoy what the night has in store.
Touring is awesome.
I mean, I feel bad that they had to wait out in the cold.
I can't feel my toes.
I've been here since two.
I've been here since what? I was the first
person in line.
Yeah.
I was the freak.
Second.
I've never waited out in the cold for a show. I wasn't allowed to go to concerts when I was a teenager.
Parents are strict and religious.
Very strict and religious. Yeah.
How does it feel to have fans this dedicated?
Meeting people on the road. You meet amazing people on the road.
Wait, is this a photo?
No. That's just a photo of my drawing, yeah.
It's like I'm looking in the mirror.
Oh, no, it's just pick a spot.
You see that?
I have a gift for you. We got 36 letters from all around the world.
Dear Brendan and Spencer, I honestly have no idea what kind of person I would be without your amazing songs.
And I'm telling you right now, Brendan,
yes?
I made your girlfriend a bracelet and she knows about it.
Great.
I'm so glad you
like your hair.
Oh, thanks. I like your hair. It's much prettier than mine.
I don't have the cool swoop going.
Oh, the swoop?
Are you guys a band?
We are, yeah. We play music, yeah.
It's called Panic at the Disco. Weird name.
Jesus, I knew you were gonna say that.
Oh, hey.
You are my niece's favorite band.
Oh, that's awesome.
For her birthday, all she wanted was your Allspock set. Can I get an autograph for her?
Oh, we'd love to. We would love to sign them. Thank you.
Oh, my God. I love you guys.
Thanks.
That's awesome.
Brown was used.
Okay, I'm not sure.
Really? I love it.
Okay.
I'm leaving that kind of thing.
So are you guys on good terms with Ryan and those guys?
Uh-huh. You know, it took a little while, but now we are.
That's a good thing.
There was a few months where we like actually didn't talk at all. Mm-hmm. And then
of course, I mean it's a close.
Yeah, and then we kind of just made up and it's great.
Good.
Just because we were all really good friends before and for almost the whole time right up till the end, and so it was just like all the band stuff becoming
totally
like a business just totally changed all that, so it's nice just to be friends.
Mm-hmm. That's
cool. My brain hurts.
Are you tired?
Yeah, dude.
Yeah,
I'm so beat. I was like,
for some reason, I was wide awake last night when we got.
Well, no, it's. And you know, it's like having to do stuff too. That in the back of your mind makes you more tired because, like, I don't want to keep going and doing interviews and, like, all that stuff. But. Yeah, then when you're done with the show, you're running on adrenaline, so you're just like.
I first, like, started performing and I would get so nervous. And, like, I'd go pee, like, five times before I had to go on stage.
I still do.
And then I'd go on stage and I still have to pee.
I know. God, did I say that at the time I almost peed on stage? For real.
I had drank like, I must have drank like, what, 10 bottles of water before we went on stage. Like, I was just coating my throat. I couldn't.
So then, 4 or 5 songs left in the set, I go back to Spencer. This is in Soma in San Diego. I go back to Spencer. I'm like, dude, listen, I'm dead serious right now. You have to stop the set, like, stall for like 3 minutes, dude.
He's like, dude, you have to take a break.
Yeah. I'm like, dude, you have to do something because I'm going to pee my pants. I have to go pee right now. I'm going to run outside the stage. I had a plan in my head. I was like, I'm going to go pee in that trash can. You just please, like, stall for like 3 minutes. He's like, no! No! Fucking sing! Like, no! It's that moment is so crucial too, because you grow more in that moment than you ever have in your life. You're like, I mean, there's nothing like a live show. There's nothing like performing for somebody. There's nothing like playing your songs, your heart, your soul, and sharing it with a mass audience. In industry terms, it has been a long time, but
God damn, I'm ready. I'm so ready.
No one could really understand how sacred that is for you, and you could never put it in words. Let's kill tonight. Vices to find the virtues, I guess, and the other way around. You know, the virtues give you a sense of the vices that are present, or that you're more aware of them. I guess I used to think that would be more of a struggle. It was more of a struggle, but now it's more of like a, you need one for the other. It's the yin and yang. It's the, you know, it's just the balance. And that's a hard thing too, but that's the beauty of going through the process, is it's a roller coaster and it's not ever going to be completely balanced. But taking those two extremes, I guess, makes for better experiences and makes for harder learning experiences. But ultimately, the lesson at the end of it is, I mean, you've grown so much more, you know, through going through those processes. Forward, and wherever that means, wherever we end up, it's a complete mystery, but forward is a good start, I think.
I missed that. Let's do that. Let's do just
Let's
that.
Let's do this again.
Let's do this again.
We should do this again.
There's no way.
Oh, man.
I would have taken a breath down.
Right?
Yeah.